There are means of increasing your iman. In iman, as we believe, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah decreases with sin and increases with good deeds. So to increase your iman, first of all, you have to do everything that Allah mandated and made obligatory upon you. You have to know Allah, so which means that to increase your iman, you have to increase the amount of knowledge. Without knowledge, you are just doing rituals without thinking about them. When you read the Quran, mashallah, how many juzu have you finished? I finished the Quran every 1 month. Mashallah, a juzu a day. Yes. Do you know the meaning? No. When are you going to start? Allah Kareem. No. It is more important for you to understand the meaning of the verses of Allah, of the Quran, rather than to keep it by heart or to recite it every day. Because the Quran was revealed to be contemplated, to be comprehended, to be understood and applied in our lives. One of the means to increase your iman is to surround yourself with righteous practicing people. If I surround myself with brothers that only love football, all what we talk about during the day is football. If I surround myself with brothers who only like R&B and rap, all what we talk about is Jay-Z and Puffy Dog, whatever the names are. If I surround myself with brothers who are practicing, whenever I sit with them, if I do this, he says, brother, drink with your right, because Al-Rasul forbade us from drinking the left. Jazakallah khair. He gave me an advice. If he doesn't see me, Fajr, he calls me in the Dhuhr, brother, I hope you're well. I didn't see you in Fajr prayer. Jazakallah khair. Next time, tomorrow, I'm going to be careful to be in Fajr. They give me advice. Whenever they see me do something wrong, they advise me. They increase my knowledge. At least, if I'm not with them, when they mention my name, they mention my name in good. They don't backbite me. So surrounding yourself with righteous and good people increases your iman. Voluntary acts, such as night prayer. A lot of the Muslims don't pray night prayer. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allah the Almighty said, and my servant would not get closer to me with deeds better than the mandatory deeds or worship that I have mandated upon him. And my servant continues to offer voluntary deeds until I love him. And if I love him, I become his sight that he sees with. I become his hearing that he hears with. I become his hand that he hits with. I become his leg that he walks with. And he continues to get closer to me. And the more he gets closer, I get closer to him. By what? By offering voluntary deeds. And would it be proper for a Muslim not to pray night prayer? Would it be proper for a Muslim not to offer witr? Say, Shaykh, I'm happy. I pray 5 times a day. Once in the masjid and 4, I delay them at the end of the night, but I pray 5 times a day. This is not a proper practicing Muslim. A proper practicing Muslim has a portion of the night where he's alone with Allah. Nobody's watching you. Nobody's looking at you. But you're praying to whom? To Allah Azza wa Jal. And that is why when you say Allahu Akbar, you feel that the whole world is in your hand. And that's why in the Fatiha, when you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah says, my servant has praised me. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, my servant has complimented me. Maliki Yawm al-Din, my servant has glorified me. Allah is talking to you. Do you feel this when you say Al-Fatiha? No, I just want the Imam to finish. If he says Alif Lam Mim, holy. He's going to take ages now. And I'm going to think, okay, it's going to take 15 minutes. Then we have to go and pick some of my friends and go to the stadium. May Allah make it easy. But when he says, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ, all right, you're my man. Keep on doing the good thing. So you have to see, why is it that my iman is down? Why is it that I don't know, I can't find any feeling and a nice taste to prayer? Because I am away from Allah. Ages and hundreds of light years away. How to get closer? Increase your iman, inshallah, and Allah knows best.